Hi, I'm Roy Hill.
I hear the train a-coming. It's rolling around a bend.
This is where you needed three hands, Roy Hill. The door was coming off.
Yeah, it was. We got in high gear, and I seen it come open with me, and I grabbed high gear and grabbed the door at the same time, and just luckily the door stayed on.
I learned business, and my good friend Raymond Beadle used to tell me, if you would work as hard at doing something right and legal as you do trying to do something and cut corners, you'd be a whole lot better off.
I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die.
I learned at a young age, 8, 9 years old, to work in the fields in tobacco and corn and beans and things like that. And it was me and my mom living with my grandmother and grandfather. I can remember making enough money the first summer I worked to buy me 3 pair of blue jeans and 4 shirts, some underwear and some t-shirts and socks. That was the greatest feeling that I can ever tell you what it felt like. And I remember back then to be able to help my mama. I guess the first company that really realized that I didn't know how to read was Lincoln Mercury Ford whenever I signed my contract for them in 1982, three, something like that. I told him, I said, I don't understand this. I don't know how to read it. Well, he said, you didn't know how to read the first contract I gave you. I said, well, how'd you know that? He said, because you looked over for about 3 minutes and signed it.
But Roy Hill's run to the Pro Stock Championship was that of a man possessed. Dropping current world championship points leader Ricky Smith in the opening round of competition, Bob Glidden's incredible motocraft Thunderbird in round two, the 1987 Pro-Am Nationals Pro Stock Champion Tim Neighbors in the third round, and of course Jerry Haas, the chassis builder in the final, was one of the greatest displays of natural driving talent we've seen in Pro Stock Eliminator this year.
Would it be safe to say you would do whatever it took to race?
I'd do whatever it took to race. Sometimes it was the right thing, sometimes it wasn't. But whatever it took, it's worse than any addiction that you can ever have. It's tough to say what I just said. I'd do whatever it took to go racing.